Hey everyone, and welcome to another video. Now, as the grass court season is in full swing, I've been making the most of it and I've been taking my last few weeks' tennis sessions out on the grass courts. If you watched last week's video, you will have seen that I played a practice tiebreak against Henry Bowden. In fact, in that session, we actually played for over an hour before that. And in this video, I'm going to share with you some of the footage from that training session, and I'm going to talk to you about some of the more specific things that we were looking at in preparation for the grass court season. Let's check it out. Welcome back. So in this session, we started off like any other session and started very gently in the service boxes, just working on a little bit of footwork, finding our timing and rhythm and getting a bit of control before we worked our way back to the baseline. Henry has a few grass court events coming up, so what he really wanted from this session was just to feel really confident on the grass. He hadn't played much on the grass beforehand this year, so our first hour was basically hitting lots and lots of tennis balls, lots of repetitions, so that he can feel super comfortable going into his first events. A few things to consider when playing on grass is that the ball bounces much lower and it travels a little bit faster than most other surfaces. With that in mind, it's really important that you stay light on your toes, but you stay low and athletic, ready to pounce on every ball. We hit lots of forehands and backhands straight up and down the middle, focusing on clean hitting and hitting to a good length. Hitting to a good depth is one of the most important things when playing on grass court. It puts a lot of pressure on your opponent, even if you're not hitting the ball super fast. If you can do this keeping the ball lower over the net than you normally do as well, that's a bonus. After we hit up and down the middle, we move to hitting some forehands on the cross court, again working on trying to get our timing and hitting to a good depth. When we moved on to the backhand side, we did the same thing, but we actually incorporated a lot more slice backhands as well, as when playing on grass, the slice is really effective. Something else that can help you when playing on grass or on any fast surface is keeping a slightly more compact swing. Making your backswing more compact can save you valuable time that you don't have when playing on that fast surface. I actually tried to do this on any surface at the start of any session just to find my timing, as it's much easier for you to get your racket in the right place at the right time. Once I feel more comfortable and confident, that's when I'll start to increase the size of my backswing. But generally on grass, your backswing should be much smaller than it is on other surfaces, as you don't have that extra time. Of course, when playing on grass, as it's a natural surface, there are some uneven bounces. As you can see, these grass courts are in really, really good condition, but even so, there are still some slightly dodgy bounces. So keeping that compact swing, staying nice and low, will allow you to adapt more easily to those bounces. Once Henry was happy with his forehands and backhands and that he was timing the ball well, he came into the net, hit some volleys. Henry spent a decent amount of time up at the net hitting volleys, as he's going to be making use of them very much more so than he would on any other surface. His aim when playing on grass is to get into the net as soon as possible to take those dodgy bounces out of the equation and to finish the point a little bit quicker. Later on in the session, Henry and I would warm up our serves and returns and play the tiebreak that you saw in last week's video. If you haven't seen that yet, I'll pop it up in the link above here. But before we hit serves and returns and played competitively, we did a couple of grass court specific drills to help Henry to improve his approaching the net and finishing the point. The way this drill works is player A, that was me, feeds in a slow mid-court ball, allowing player B, which was Henry, to attack. Now for the purpose of this drill, with the grass court being super fast, I was positioned slightly off center of the middle of the baseline, feeding that ball into Henry's forehand. Henry was to attack his shot down the line and to follow it in to finish the point up at the net. This drill is fantastic for both Henry and I, as Henry can really work on his attacking skills and I can also work on my defensive skills. If you were doing this on a slightly slower surface, the feeder could change their position slightly. They could move slightly further away from where they need to get to, giving the other person more of a space. With a slower surface, the defender will have slightly more time to get to that ball. However, on grass, I would have no hope. Another thing you could do on a slower surface to make it more challenging for the defender is for the attacker to have the option of going down the line or cross court. In this instance, Henry had to go down the line to give us an even chance and to allow me to defend effectively, but also to allow Henry to have that third ball.
No!
Had to go cross there.
Nearly.
We played on the forehand side for a good 10 minutes before moving on to me feeding to his backhand. We did exactly the same thing. However, on the backhand side, Henry had two options when going down the line. He was either to drive the ball or to slice it. And in my opinion, Henry was far better at hitting that slice down the line. It was deadly. The ball stayed super low and it skidded through, making my forehand really difficult to time well.
I'm not sure.
You'll notice that when Henry was attacking, he was doing a really good job at hitting his shot low over the net and keeping it to a good length. Every time Henry hit that ball near to the baseline, I really struggled to defend. Most of the time, I had to go for a passing shot, as I knew that defending high, he'd just kill the point.
On the line.
Where are you, drone?
So next time you're in a practice session with your hitting partner, consider using this drill, especially if you or your partner want to work on attacking or defending. It's a really good way to add a different challenge into your training sessions and to add something slightly more specific to what you want to work on. It was absolutely ideal for Henry going into the grass court season, as his aim, like I said earlier, is to keep the point short. Anytime he sees the opportunity with a slightly slower or shorter ball, he wants to pounce on it and follow it into the net to finish the point. So I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. As always, consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't done so already, and let me know if you've done anything similar to this in the comments below. I look forward to seeing you in next week's video. Take care.